world, welcome to my short little Halloween video. This video is going to be short and little because A, my camera battery is dying, and B, I don't have that much to say, but I did want to do a quick little Halloween video, so here it is! I don't really have a costume, so I'm wearing my koala onesie, which is really cute, so I hope that's okay. So this year I had three Halloween reads, and the first book I want to talk about is The Ocean at the End of the Lane by Neil Gaiman. I really wanted to read a Gaiman book for Halloween, and this is one that I still had and hadn't read, so that's why I picked it up. So the book is about this little boy who is unnamed, I think, and he's also the narrator of the story. It's sort of a frame narration told by him when he's older, but the core of the story takes place when he is 7 years old. He meets this girl called Letty Hemstick, who lives with her mother and grandmother at the end of his lane a few miles down the road on an old farm. Letty and her family are kind of different from other people, as the narrator soon finds out, and with Letty he encounters things that he didn't think were true. What I enjoyed most about the book is seeing the story unfold through the perspective of a seven-year-old. I think it was really lovely how he doesn't question anything, he just goes with the flow. In retrospect, this maybe wasn't the best book to read for Halloween, but it does have a monster in it and some other scary stuff. And I'd already recently read Coraline and some other short stories that are in the back of my copy, so that would have been perfect, but I'd already read that. It's a good book though, and I would definitely recommend it to people who like magical realism and who like Neil Gaiman stories. The second book I want to talk about is A Cat, A Hat, and A Piece of String by Joanne Harris. Now this is a collection of short stories, and the reason I picked it up is because on the back it says, meet the ghost who lives on a Twitter timeline, be spooked by a newborn baby created with sugar, spice, and lashings of cake. So I thought, yes. I have to say I liked this book, but I didn't love it. Some of the stories were really appropriate for Halloween, some not so much, but I think that's to be expected in a collection of short stories which will have different genres. I'm planning to do a full book review on this book, so I'm not going to go into detail any further because, again, the battery of my camera really is dying. Blinking red lights! The final book that I want to talk about is, I think, the Halloween read of the year, and it's Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children by Ransom Riggs. Do you like my bookmark? The lovely Renee loaned me this book, thank you Renee, and I'm currently reading it as you can tell from the bookmark. I just started it this morning and I'm currently at chapter 3, so I can't really tell you too much about it yet, except that I'm really enjoying it actually. I'm interested to see where the story's going to go exactly. I'll put a few links to book reviews from other booktubers in the description because I've only just started reading it, so there really isn't any more I can tell you about it. This was my really short Halloween video, I hope you liked it, and I'll see you again next time. Choking in this thing.